and welcome to Living Supernaturally. This week we have been studying about this topic of God imitators. You and I, we are called to imitate God. And that's not an act of pride, but it's really something, it's a privilege for us to be like Him. And Ephesians 5 and verse 1 is the verse that we've been looking at. Therefore, be imitators of God as dear children. In other words, it says that since God is your heavenly Father and you are His children because you have been born again, be imitators of God. So to be like Him is our privilege. And to be like Him is something that we are exhorted. 3 John and verse 11 says, Beloved, do not imitate what is evil, but imitate what is good. So when we imitate God, who is good and who is righteous, we are imitating Him, and we are called to do that. Okay, one of the aspects that we can imitate about God is His holiness. We are called to imitate His holiness. We need to understand that the Lord has already cleansed us, and He has washed us when we accepted Him as our Lord and Savior. On the cross, He forgave us, He washed us, He cleansed us, and He clothed us with His righteousness. He covered us with His righteousness. 2 Corinthians 5 and verse 21 says this, For He made Him who knew no sin to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in Him. Right? So from that place, or having been clothed in righteousness, the righteousness of God, we are called to walk in holiness. 1 Peter 1 and verse 13 to 16, Therefore gird up the loins of your mind, be sober, and rest your hope fully upon the grace that is to be brought to you at the revelation of Jesus Christ. As obedient children, not conforming yourselves to the former lusts as in your ignorance, but as he who called you is holy, you also be holy in all your conduct, because it is written, Be holy, for I am holy. So the Lord invites us and He says, Be holy, for I am holy. So He's saying, you know, this is my character, this is my nature, and I'm your heavenly Father, and I'm calling you, my children, to be just like me, to be holy, even as I am holy. And Peter exhorts us here in this scripture that we read, and he says, as obedient children, you know, if we want to obey God, and if we want to be holy like Him, he says, do not conform yourselves to your former lusts. Meaning, understand what you and I have been saved from, redeemed from. He says, do not go back and fit yourself into those former lusts. Those things of the flesh that actually brought us down, that brought us into bondage, do not conform yourselves. And in Colossians 3 and verse 5, we are called to put to death our members and be holy and walk in holiness. So today, let us ask God to give us that enabling power by the Holy Spirit to be like Him and to walk in holiness. Let's pray. Father, we thank You because You've invited us to walk in holiness. Holy Spirit, we thank You that You indwell us and You help us to walk in holiness. We thank You, God, for covering us with Your righteousness. And from that place, God, yes, Lord, we will walk in Your footsteps, in our choices, in the things that we see, in what we hear, in our conversations, God. We will be holy just like You who is holy. We thank You. We give You all the praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.